Okay.
Thank you, Hui Ting. I'll now end up our presentation by discussing about the present and future of IB in Asia. In ECM, we have seen some signs of bright spots. And at the same time, regional financial integration has been rather active. Like for SGX, it has added its first currency clearing member 2 weeks ago. But we have to ask ourselves whether all these are sustainable in the long run. Because we cannot forget that there are still investors out there who are passive after the last financial crisis. For this year, we have been talking about the growing importance of local currency debt markets. But this does not come without any country-specific risk, like for the case we have seen in Vietnam. In M&A, we have also been seeing a consistent pattern of significant deals, like for the case of Malaysia and Indonesia. Yet, if you really think ahead, Japan's M&A volume dropped as soon as its yen depreciated. So does that mean that all the countries in Asia have strong currencies to move themselves ahead? All in all, in Asia, we have seen that IBs have been having failing revenues in the last 3 years. But in the recent 3 months, domestic IBs in Asia has brought about increasing revenues. With that, how do you think IBs in Asia will play out as a whole in future? We would like to end our presentation with that and we'll discuss this question during our Q&A.